In this example, we'll look at distillation in a batch system where we start out with a liquid that has a mole fraction of 0.2 of component 1. And this particular system, whose temperature mole fraction diagram is shown here, has an azeotrope at about a mole fraction of 0.5. What we want to do is plot how does the temperature change as a function of time as we carry out this batch distillation. Approximately, how does it change? Assuming we have a constant heat input to the system. And then how does the composition of the vapor change, if it does change, as we remove the vapor from the system as we evaporate the liquid? And then explain the reasons for the particular shapes of these two graphs. So, just a simple diagram to explain exactly what we're doing. If we had a container, we put in a liquid whose mole fraction here is 0.2 for component 1. And we're going to supply heat at a constant rate, so we're going to evaporate, done at constant pressure. The pressure corresponding to this plot. This plot is at constant pressure, let's say 1 bar. And we're going to continuously remove this vapor from the system. And we want to know, one of the questions is, what's the composition of this vapor as a function of time? So if we look at the diagram and we start with a liquid, example here, it's our starting point, mole fraction of 0.2, and supply heat. First, of course, we heat the liquid up until it gets to this point. The vapor that's in equilibrium with the liquid has to be at the same temperature, and so the vapor composition is approximately 0.05 mole fraction of component 1. And so we remove this vapor, and as we continue to supply heat, we're going to now move along this line. The composition of the liquid is going to become enriched in component 1 because the vapor is enriched in component 2, or depleted in component 1. And as we move along to now this liquid, well, the composition in the vapor will increase in component 1, but we're still preferentially removing component 2. So we'll continue to move along this composition of enriching the liquid in component 1 until we get to this point, where now the vapor and the liquid have the same composition. This is the azeotrope. So at this point, the vapor composition will not change as a function of time until we evaporate the rest, and likewise the temperature will not change. And so let's represent this behavior now in plots. So I'm showing here temperature versus time, where we start at 95 degrees. And so this is the liquid's temperature increasing based on heat capacity. Here we have vaporization. Vaporization starts at 100 degrees and continues up to 117. So as the liquid mole fraction of component 1 increases, the temperature is going from 100 to about 117. And then we reach the azeotrope. And now we're due the rest of the vaporization, but with no further temperature increase. And here is the corresponding mole fraction change. So we don't have any vapor being produced until we get to 100 degrees. And then the mole fraction of the vapor, if we look at the diagram, when the liquid is 0.2, the vapor is about 0.05. And then the mole fraction increases. It's not a linear increase. It's just an approximate curve here. Until we get to vapor mole fraction of 0.5, which is also the liquid mole fraction. And then at the azeotrope, the liquid and the vapor have the same composition. We're at constant temperature, and we're not changing the mole fraction. So this is the vaporization, just like on the previous graph. And I haven't made the time scales exactly the same, but the behavior is this vaporization occurs, of course, from here to here, and then the azeotrope occurs here. So we're carrying out batch distillation on a system with an azeotrope. The boiling temperature will change until we reach the azeotrope, and then it'll stay constant, and likewise the composition of vapor will change until we reach the azeotrope.